I am sitting in the education room of an exhibition of Edward Gorey's drawings entitled Elegant Enigmas. The name was actually coined by his biographer, who really felt that Gorey was that kind of unknowable character, that type of artist that was so steeped in so many traditions of not only art making, but literature and theater, that it's fairly unknowable who he is. And so he remains an enigma to this day. And yet there's a certain very idiosyncratic character that she decided he wanted to characterize as being elegant. He's a one-of-a-kind artist. He is one of those true individuals of art making for whom I'm not sure there are quite very many precedents, especially in illustration. If I were to kind of put him in a class of artists, I would put him in the same class as maybe Charles Adams, Shel Silverstein, Maurice Sendak. Those are the three that come to mind, and they really are so singular in their vision that there's no mistaking a Gorey drawing. I think one of the great things about all four of them, but Gorey in particular, is one of those artists that appeals as much to children as he does to adults, which is a very hard thing to do. And perhaps like Looney Tunes when we were children, and their kind of secondary meanings may have been lost on us, but now as adults they become even more fun. Gorey drawings are about the same thing. I think the beauty of them is they explore these funny little areas that perhaps you don't want to look at, but he characterizes them in such a way that we're able to accept them. The exhibition is actually drawn in this incarnation exclusively from the holdings of the Edward Gorey Trust. They've been very cooperative in allowing us to really mobilize his imagery and his characters. As you can see around me, we've created this Gorey scene in which everybody can come and have their photograph taken within a Gorey drawing. And that's usually something that trusts are a little loath to do, but I have to tell you, they've been incredibly easy to work with. What you'll see is a selection of drawings from some of his most well-known works. You know, he was incredibly prolific. The things that I tell people to really concentrate on are really the line work. What you'll see when we walk through is that I've included both the books and magnifying glasses wherever possible to correspond to the drawings on the wall. I did the books because it's very important to know that Gorey always worked in exactly the scale that the book would appear. And so by the time he was ready to draw, the story was already in place, he knew what he was going to draw, and it was a matter of accomplishing it. And so he was always thinking in book form when he was making drawings for a book. And the other thing, the magnifying glasses are, you really can't appreciate Gorey unless you can get right up into these drawings. The line work is unbelievably exquisite, to say nothing, you know, of it just being a tour de force of how to expressively use line to denote not only shape, form, and situation, but also emotion. And that's what I really tell people. It's like, if you have 20 minutes to spare, pick one drawing that you like and just immerse yourself in it. An Edward Gorey drawing was the first piece of art I ever tried to buy. The key word there being tried, because as much money as I had, they were always just a bit more, so they were the ever elusive piece of art, and I, to this day, have never been able to find an Edward Gorey drawing to buy. Never did. But that's why coming to the Norton and having this exhibition already scheduled, it was just serendipitous, and when they asked me if I'd like to install it, it was just perfect.